prerequisite of this Reddix sort is counting sort, because we are going to use counting sort as a subroutine in Reddix sort. Fine. So I recommend you to please go through that video first of all. That counting sort I have uploaded. I'll provide you the link in the description box. You can check out there. If you know how count sort works, then you can easily get the Reddix sort. If you don't know the working of counting sort, then it would be very tough for you, I guess, to understand this Reddix sort. So first of all, go through that video. So let us take this example. We are going to take this array, fine. Number of elements are 10, and we are going to apply Reddix sort on this array. Why we cannot apply counting sort on such kind of array, that I have already discussed in the previous video, fine. What are the drawbacks of counting sort? Okay, so please go through that link first of all, then come to this video, fine. Now see, how counting sort would be applied here. I told you in that video, in this case counting sort would be applied digit by digit, fine, according to the place value of the digit. See, like we have three digits in this. Let us suppose we are going to take this one, 199. So we are having three digits, so three time counting sort would be applied. First of all, on this 9, then this 9, then this 1, according to the place value. See, this value is what? Ones. This is what? Tens. This is what? Hundreds. I hope you know the place value. Fine. See, we cannot apply, this is the, you can say, the least significant bit, or this is the most significant bit. So we are going to start from the least significant bit and we are going towards most significant bit. You cannot apply on the most significant bit and go to least significant bit, because that, in that case the array would not be sorted. If numbers are given, if in, the strings values are given, names are given, in that case you apply from MSB to LSB. But in case of integers or numbers, you are going to apply from LSB to MSB. In this direction we are going to apply counting sort, fine. So first of all, how many times counting sort would be applied, that you have to count. So out of given array, first thing is you have to find out the maximum data. In this array the maximum data is what? 677. And count how many digits are there in the maximum data, 1, 2 and 3 digits. So how many times counting sort would be applied? 3 times. Now you are supposed to make all the numbers 3 digit numbers. So this is 8. How you can make it a 3 digit number? Just add 2 zeros to the this side, fine, not to the right hand side, to the left hand side. Here 10, here 10, here we have 10, here we have 10. Now all the numbers are 3 digit numbers. Now we are done with our first step. Now next step is what? You are supposed to apply now the counting sort. Now I am going to show you how actually count sort would be applied in Reddix sort. So 3 passes would be there. Now first pass. In first pass you are going to apply count sort in, on this place value, on the ones place. Here you can say, here, here. On these key values, on the least significant bit, we are going to apply the count sort. Fine. Now see, what is the procedure to apply count sort? We are going to take one count array, and the size of this count array would be, see, in Reddix sort, the what is the k value? Ranges from 0 to 9. Because the, see, each digit would be either 0, 1 or 2 or up to 9. So you are going to take the range 0 to 9. So k value is 9. So the size of this count array is what? 10. So this is our count array, size is 10. And first of all, we are going to initialize this array with 0. Now what you are going to fill in this array? We are going to count the elements, the frequency of the elements according to the distinct key values. Fine, that I have discussed in count sort. That is why I am again and again saying please watch that video first of all. So here counting sort would be applied in first pass on this digit, on the least significant digit. So check out this digit. Here we have 2, fine. So here we have 2, then go to the index 2 and increment this counter. That is 1. Next, we are going to take first that variable I, and we are going to start a loop. Now I value would be incremented. Here we have I, and check out this digit. Here we have 8. So go to the index 8 and increment this value. Here we have 0. Go to the index 0 and increment this value. Here again we have 0 on the least significant digit, or you can say at the ones place. So again go to index 0 and increment this count value. Fine. Here we have 8, go to the 8th index, increment this value. Here we have 1, go to the index 1, increment this value. Again 1, increment this value. 5, increment value at index 5. 7, go to index 7, increment this value. 9, go to index 9, increment this value. That is done. Now this is our count array. We know now, see in this case 9 is only one time, at the ones place only. Because now we are applying the count sort on the one digit only. Fine. Now you are going to update this count array. Second step was, we are going to update this count array and such that this count array would contains the actual position of these elements in the sorted array. Fine. So how to update this count array? See, we are going to update this count array only. Fine. I am just making another array just for the understanding purpose. So see, first what is the step? First value would be as it is. Now next step would be how to fill this value. Here is, we have 2 and the next value is 2, so 2 plus 2 is 4. Fine. At position 4, or you can say index 3, till index 3 1 would be there in the sorted array. Fine. See, this funda I have clearly explained when I was explaining count sort. Fine. So please check out that video. Now we are going to add 4 plus 1, that is 5. 5 plus 0 is 5. 5 plus 0 is 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. 6 plus 0 is 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. 7, 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. Fine. So this is the actual position of these elements in the sorted, when you are going to find out the sorted array. Now what you will do? Now we are going to build the output array. Fine. We are going to sort these elements according to one digit only, that is according to this digit only, first of all. Now you are going to build a array. Now take another array. Suppose I am going to take an array B, and that array would be same as size array A, the original array given. So now this is array B. How to build this array? What was the procedure? See, we are going to scan this array from right to left. Why this? Because to maintain the stability property of this counting sort. Here, scan this. Here we have, suppose I, the element at this place is 9. So go to the index 9 in count array and the value is 10. See, this is the updated count array. We are going to check this one. We are not going to check this one. Value is 10, but this is count. Fine. And we are going to apply, we are going to work with the indexes. So first of all, we will decrease this 10 minus 1, that is 9, and at 9th index you will put this number 199. So here you will put 199. This is index 9. Fine. Now decrement I value, check out this number, key value 7, go to the index 7, value is 7. First decrement this value, that is 6. Now go to the index 6 and place this value 677. Decrement again I value, here we have 5, go to the index 5, here we have 6. Decrement this first of all, that is 5, go to index this 5, this is index 5. Next is 1, go to the index 1, here is, we have 4. Decrement this value. At index 3 in this output array, place this value 011. Again decrement I, we have 231, value is 1. Go to the index 1. Decrement this value, that is 2. On second index, we are going to store 231. Now decrement I, here we have 8 at ones place. Go to the index 8, here we have 9. Decrement this first of all 8. At 8th index, you will store 88. Now again decrement I, here we have 0. Go to the 0th index. Here we have 2. Count value is 2. Decrement this, that is 1. In index 1 in the output array, place this value, that is 90. Decrement I value 530, means we have 0 here. Go to the index 0, decrement this value, that is 0. At 0th index you will store what? 530. Decrement I value 8, we have 8 now at ones place. Go to the index 8, value is 8, decrement this, that is 7. At 7 you are going to place this 8. Now this value 2, go to the index 2, here we have 5, decrement this 4, here you will put 432. Now we are going to store because we have reached to index 0. Now this is our array after pass 1. See, we have just sorted the array, we have applied the count sort on only one digit. We are still remaining with 2 digits. So this is now the array. Now we are going to apply. This is now your array, updated array. What you can do, you can just copy these elements into this array with applying a one for loop. Fine. Now this is our updated array. Now we are going to apply the count sort again on which digit? The digit which is at 10th place. Here, this one, second, this one. Same procedure would be followed for this digit. Same, you are going to build this count array, same you are going to fill this array, and now again you are going to build the output array. Fine. So this is pass 2 now. Same, we are going to take the count array. Again, we are going to initialize this count array with values 0. Fine. See, we are going to update the same array. It's not like here count array is different, here count array is different. The same array you are going to take in the program. I'm just drawing this array again and again. See, now how to fill this array? We'll counter the frequency of the elements. See, now I would be started from here. Now we are going to apply count sort on this digit, the digit at 10th place. Now here we have 3, go to the index 3 in the count array and increment this value. Next, increment I, here we have 9, go to the index 9, increment this value. Here we have 3, increment at index 3, increment this value. Go to index 3 and increment this value. Next, we have 1, go to index 1, increment this value. Next is 3, go to the index 3, increment this value. Next is 4, go to index 4, increment this value. Next is 7, go to index 7, increment this value. Next is, see, second digit here is 0, fine. So go to index 0, increment this value. Here we have 8, go to index 8, increment this value. Here we have 9, go to index 9, increment this value. Now this is our count array. Now we are going to update this count array to reflect the actual position of these numbers or elements in the sorted array. Now how we are going to update this count array? Same method would be followed. First value would be as it is, the value at 0th index. We are going to start the loop from 1 to here. K value is 9 here. Range is 0 to 9. Fine. So how you will apply, how to find out that position? This 1 plus 1, that is 2. Position would be 2, but index would be 1 in this array. Fine. 2 plus 0, 2. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 1, 6. 6 plus 0, 6. 6 plus 0, 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. 7 plus 1 is 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. So this is now the updated count array. Fine. Now you are going to build. Third step is you are going to build the output array. You are going to take another array B. See, we have just this, we are going to update this array, only. It's not like that in the program we are going to take one B array, again another B array. No, we have one B array only. You are going to update this array only. Just I am drawing the array again and again. Now, how to build this output array? See, this is now our array. We are going to scan this array from right to left. See, the after pass 1, this is the updated array. We are not going to check this array now, we are going to check this array. Fine. Now, scan this one. First of all, I is at this place. Now we are applying count sort on this digit only. You are going to check this array, this digit only. Here we have 9. So go to the index 9 in count array and value is 10. But first of all, we will decrease this, that is 9. And in this output array at 9th index, we are going to store this 199. See, this is the updated count array. You are not going to check this one now. Fine. Decrement I. Here second place, digit is 8. Go to the index 8. Here we have value 8. Decrement this first of all 7. At index 7, you are going to store 88. Again, decrement this. Here at second digit, we have 0. Go to the index 0. At here, we have 1. First of all, decrement this. That is 0. Then go to the 0th index and store this value. 8. Fine. Like this, same step would be applied and you are going to fill this array. So now, this is the array, output array. Fine. We are just going to copy this numbers into the original array, that is A. So now after pass 2, the updated array is this one. We have applied counting sort 2 times. Now one remaining. We are going to apply count sort on this digit now, this one, on the digit which is at hundreds place. Okay. Now in pass 3, same steps would be applied. We are going to build this count array. Same size would be 10. We are now applying the count sort on which digit? This one. This one. The digit which is at hundreds place. So now count, first of all, first step is we are going to count the number of times, so you can say frequency of this key value, this element. Fine. So now again loop would be started from here. Check out this digit. Here we have 0. The value is 0. Go to the index 0. See, same steps. We are going to first of all initialize again this count array with 0. Fine. Now we are going to increment this value. Go to index 0, increment this value. Now I would be incremented. Here we have 0. Go to 0th index, increment this value. Here we have 5. Go to index 5, increment this value. Here we have 2, go to index 2, increment this value. Next, here we have 4, go to index 4, increment this value. Here we have 0, go to index 0, increment this value. Next is 6, increment this value. 0, go to index 0, increment this value. Next again 0, go to index 0, increment this value. And next is 1, index 1, increment this value. Fine. So this is now the count array. Now we are going to update this count array just to reflect the actual position. So now the updated count array would be, see why we have 5 at 0th index, I guess you got the concept. See, we are applying this count sort here only, so 0 at this place, how many times 0 is there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 times. That is why the count array, the frequency is 5 here. Fine. So now we are going to update this count array. How to update this? First value would be as it is 5. Now 5 plus 1, that is 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 7, 7 plus 1, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, and here we have 10, 10 and 10. Now this is our updated count array. Now we are going to build the output array. Same, another array is there, that is B array. You are going to update this B array only. See, now this is the updated array after pass 2. So we are going to scan this from this right to left. So start from here, the value at index this the hundreds place, because in this pass we are applying this counting sort at this digit only. So here value is 1. Go to index 1 and the value is in count sort is 6. So we are first of all decrease this, that is 5. At 5th index we are going to store 199. Fine. Now again decrement this I, here we have 0, go to the index 0, here we have 5, decrement this, that is 4. At 4 we are going to place 90. Now decrement I value, here we have again 0, go to index 0, in decrement this, that is 3. At 3rd we are going to store 88. Now decrement this, here we have 6, go to index 6, value is 10, decrement this, that is 9. At 9th index we are going to store 677. Like this, you are going to follow the steps, and now finally you get the sorted array. So now this is our output array after pass 3. As you can see, this array is now sorted. You simply copy the element of this array, the B array, into array A, the original array, and you got the sorted array. This is how you are going to apply the radix sort. See how many times you applied counting sort here? 3 times. Why 3 times? Because in the maximum element in the array, the number of digits are only 3. See, I tried my level best to explain this radix sort in an easy way. I hope you got the concept. If you got the concept, then please let me know in the comment box. Fine. See now. Now we are going to write down the code for this radix sort. So we'll take one function, that is radix sort. In this, you are going to pass array A and number of elements in that array. So now in this radix sort, we are going to call what? Counting sort. And how many times? For this example, 3 times, because maximum element is this one and the number of digits in this element is 3 only. Maybe in another case you have maximum element is 1, 4, 3, 2. So here in maximum data the number of digits are 4, so 4 times you are going to call the count sort. So first of all you are going to find out the maximum element, right? So you are going to write down a function I'm not going to write down the code for that function. I'm simply write down that function. Suppose we are going to take getMax, a function. We are going to pass array A and number of elements. And this getMax will return the maximum element in this array. So we are going to store this into a variable, suppose max. Fine. In max now we have the maximum element. So in this case, max, in max we have the 677. So now you are going to apply a for loop. Fine. See, we are going to call the counting sort on the position. First on this position, then this position, then this position. Ones, tens, and hundreds. So I am going to take a variable position, or you can say POS. I am going to initialize it with 1. And now the condition is, here we have the maximum data in variable max. Max divide by this pose is greater than 0, and this pose would be incremented by into 10, not plus 10, into 10. And now we are going to call this count sort. So we are going to pass some arguments here. I'm going to tell you that thing later. First of all, why you are incremented this post value into 10? See, first of all, position is this 1 position, next position is tens. So 1, then next position is 10, next position is hundreds. So 10 into 10, that is 100. That is why I'm incrementing this into 10. Fine. Now in count sort, you'll pass array A, number of elements in the array, plus this value, this position value, at which position you are supposed to call this count sort. So you are going to call at POS position. First of all, ones, then tens, then hundreds would be passed. And this is it. So this is the code for redX sort. Now we are going to write down the code for this count sort. In main function, you are going to call this redX sort. See, in this case, if you call this redX sort, then in this, out of this array, the maximum, the value of this maximum would be 677. GetMax would be a function. You are going to write down the code for this function also to find out the maximum element out of this array. I guess you can write down the code, because here the main logic is about this redX sort. So I'm not going to write down the code for this GetMax. Fine. So maximum is 677. Now in for loop, see, we are going to take one variable, and the value is 1 here. Max divided by post. Max is 677 divided by 1. That is 677 only. That is greater than 0. So value is, condition is satisfied. Call this count sort. Array would be passed. N and post value is 1. So 1 would be passed. So now counting sort would be called in this, from this position, at this position. Fine. Now next this, after the completion of count sort, this post value would be incremented. Now post is what? 10. Now max divided by post. Max is 677 divided by 10. That is 67 only. Fine. 67 is greater than 0. Again, count sort would be post, would be called, and post value is 10. 10 would be passed. So at this place, this count sort would be called. Now next is, after the completion of count sort, now post value is 10 into 10, that is 100. 677 divided by 100, that is 6 only. 6 is greater than 0. Now again count sort would be called. Now after count sort, again post value would be 100 into 10, that is 1000. Now 677 divided by 1000, it is 0. Now 0 is not greater than 0. Now count sort would not be called. Now how many times this sorting would be called? 1, 2, and 3 times. So I hope you got the working of this for loop. Why we have written this max divided by post greater than 0. Now we are going to write down the code for this count sort. We have discussed the count sort. 4 loops would be there. You have just do a little bit modification for this redX sort. Logic would be same. Fine. Now we are going to define this count sort. So here you are going to take what? Int of this array A, int n you can say, and int. Now write down the count sort. 4 loops would be there. Now start with the first step is, just take a count, you can say this count array, And the size of count array is here is fixed, that is 0 to 9 range. So count array would be 10. So just take 10, size is 10, and initialize it with 0 first of all. That is the first step in this count sort function. Next step is, now you have to fill this count sort array. How we are going to fill? We are going to count the frequency of the elements. Now, one for loop would be applied. We have started I is equal to from 0. I would be less than n and I plus plus. So now what we have done here, see, in first pass, we have just taken this value, that is 2. We went to the index 2 and increment this value simply. Fine. So in count sort, what we have written? Count A of I and you can say plus plus. See, this logic would not work here. Why? So because see, A of I value is this one, A of I is 432. So count 432. But we don't have any index 432, na? So we have to just take this value, this 2. We are concerned with this value only, this one, this one, this one. We are not concerned with the complete value, all the three digits, no. So you have to find out this digit from this number. Now how to find out this digit? What is the logic? So what you can say to find out this digit out of this number, you can say we just do A of I mod 10, and here you can write count. So A of I is 432, 432 mod 10, that is 2. A of I is 8, 8 mod 10 is 8 only. This mod 10 is 0 only. So that is fine. But this will work only for pass 1. Because see, in second pass, you are going to deal with this digit. The digit which is at 10th place. But according to this logic, in second pass only, when I would be at this place, when you are going to start here, then 530 mod 10, that is 0. But we are going to take 3, now we have to take 3. So now what you will do? So this thing is somewhat right, but not exact. You have to modify this thing also. Now what you have to do? See, you will have to write within this for loop. So now this is the exact logic. You have to divide this number A of I by this value, this position value. Then you can do, after that you can write this mod 10. See, in first pass it will, in second pass I am going to check. See, the value is 530. 530, A of I is 530 divide by, in second pass this POS value would be incremented and it would become 10. So 530 divided by 10, it means it becomes 53, and 53 mod 10, so it becomes 3, and obviously we want this 3 only. Fine. In third pass you can check, in third pass the POS value would be 10 into 10, that is 100. So in third pass you can check again, suppose we are going to take this 530, so in third pass we are going to deal with this 5 only. 530 divide by POS value in third pass is 100. So now this divide by 100 is what? 5 only. 5 mod 10 is 5 only. So we are going to deal this 5 only. So this is the exact logic. So now next for loop would be for this array, to update this count array to reflect the actual position. So next for loop would be, we are going to start this from 1, because first value would be as it is. 1 till I less than equal to k and I plus plus. Now here what you will write, we'll simply add this plus this, next plus previous. So that is very simple. So simply you are going to write count of I is equal to same count I plus count I minus 1. This is the same we have discussed in the count sort. Now third would be to build this array. Now third for loop, we are going to start this for loop from here. We are going to scan this array from right to left. So I would be n minus 1, I would be greater than equal to 0, and I minus minus. So what we have done in this case, we have just taken 9, go to the index 9 is count sort, decrement this counter value, and in the output array B, at this index 9, we stored this value. Fine. So this value would be stored where? So this value, that is a of I, would be stored where? You are going to write down that thing here, obviously in the B array. But index would be what? So now see what you will write here. How to calculate this index, that is 9 for 199, using this count array. In count array, this value is 9. We are going to check the same index. Fine. So first of all, in out of this, out of A of I, you have to find out this 9. And you can find, in second pass, you will deal with this 9. And in third pass, you will deal with this one. How to find out these particular digits using this logic only? We have already discussed. So now what you will do, count and index, how you will calculate? Same, A of I divide by POS mod 10. Fine. This is how you are going to calculate the index of count, and then you will do index this value minus minus, then you will do minus minus. So you can take one example. See, let us take the 677. A of I is 677 divide by, in first pass this POS value is only 1. So 677 divided by 1, that is 677 mod 10. Mod 10 means 7 only. So here you will write count 7. Fine. Now count 7 minus minus. Go to the index 7. Here go to the index 7. Here we have 7, but minus minus, then 6. Minus minus. Here we have B. After minus minus, it becomes 6. So at B of 6, you are going to store 677. You are going to store A of I. This is how this logic will work. In second pass, same, the POS value would be passed from here, that is 10 only. So you can trace out the complete code with the help of this example. And now simply the fourth loop would be what? To copy the array of this to this. So one for loop, I is equal to from 0, I less than n, and I plus plus. And this would be just copy the elements of B array into A array. See, this is not the complete program. You are going to write down the main function. In that main function, you will call this radix sort. And you are also going to write down the code for this getMax function. Fine. But this is the main logic. You can trace out this logic with this example for each pass. I am not going to trace out this one because the video would be very lengthy. Now I am going to discuss the time complexity. See, time complexity for this count sort is what we have discussed in that video when we were discussing counting sort, that is order of n plus k. Why n plus k? Because see, how many for loops? Four loops would be there. How many times the calculation would be there within these for loops? This for loop would be from 0 to n, that is n times, this is k times, this is n times, this is n times. So 3n plus k, that is n plus k. And how many times this count sort would be called? The number of digits in the max data. Here 3 times it would be called. So you can write time complexity would be order of d into n plus k. Here d is number of digits. So 3 into n plus k. This is the time complexity for radix sort. See, one more thing for the counting sort, time complexity is this one, and as well as space complexity is also n plus k. Why so? Because in counting sort, we have taken extra arrays. One array is this count array, that would be of size k, and one extra array is this another array, that is size of the same array, that is original array. So n plus k, two arrays we have taken. So see, it is not compulsory that you will take this another array. You can modify this original array also. It's up to you how you are going to apply the logic. Fine. So this is all about radix sort. I hope you got the concept. So I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.